Welcome back to the IBFP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Errol Spence Jr. You know, a lot of people have made a lot of things about Errol Spence Jr. and, you know, how to beat him, how to convincingly get him. But we figured out the blueprint to beat Errol Spence Jr. and it's basically just watching and observing. Because once you fight enough fights, you can see a fighter's deficiencies and weaknesses and, you know, their tendencies and habits in and out of the ring. And you can kind of summarize, you know, what's the best game plan to approach to beat this fighter. Now, of course, nothing's 100% sure, nothing 100%, you know, certain, but based on what we've seen, based on what we know, and based on only the facts, we can surmise the best way to beat Errol Spence Jr. is through the body, is with body shots. His greatest strength is also his greatest weakness. Let's just break it down honestly and unbiasedly. You know, in the prediction leading up to Errol Spence versus Sean Porter, Keith Thurman says body shots would be a factor. And this is his exact quote. He says, styles make fights, you know. He's not Kell Brook, and I think body shots will matter in this fight. I expect both to be going to the body. I think dominance will be presented in the first four rounds. So I'm here as a spectator, just like you guys. Now, the interesting thing about Keith Thurman's statement is he said, I think, you know, body shots will matter. And he said, I expect both to go to the body. He didn't just say Errol Spence. He said Sean Porter. A lot of questions have been asked about if Errol Spence can take body shots. People have been wondering that. People have been questioning that ever since Terrence Crawford dared, you know, Errol Spence to go to his body and stated that he would stop Errol Spence. You know, people have been wondering about this. And the fact that Sean Porter went to Errol Spence's body gave Errol Spence one of the hardest fights he's ever had. And in my opinion, he beat Errol Spence on that night. He just didn't get a fair shake from the judges. One judge did see it his way, though. So it shows that, you know, Sean Porter game plan going to the body, relentless attack, high work rate, you know, mixing up a varied attack in and out of the pocket, worked for Sean Porter, showed off everything that he could do. Because in all honesty, Sean Porter is not going to win that fight against Errol Spence, you know, based on the judges, unless he knocks him out. You know, Sean Porter did everything he was supposed to do going into that fight, and most people view it as a robbery. Even if you had it close, no one thought that Sean Porter would win the first four rounds. And what Keith Thurman stated is that dominance would be shown in the first four rounds. And he even stated, you know, during the fight that he believed Sean Porter won the first 5 to 6 rounds. So you have to understand and be honest and unbiased. Sean Porter went in there and did a fantastic job on Errol Spence. And it all started with the body attack. Let's be honest and unbiased. And then we see Errol Spence Jr. charged with a DWI, you know, in this most incident from this car crash. And the interesting thing about that is, you know, it just proves, you know, it puts all the rumors to bed. We know Errol Spence Jr. drinks. We understand that that's an issue, a constant issue in his life. But here's the thing. You know, the speculation is over. We have tangible, actual proof and evidence. And so then when you see something like Virgil Hunter saying that vodka will be Sergey Kovalev's downfall, when you see that drinking is a problem for other fighters, when you see that Sergey Kovalev has jumped on about his drinking, and you see even Kovalev says, I drink beer every day, could take some vodka too. When you see things like this, you realize that the weakness and deficiency of a fighter, you know, starts with the body because of the drinking. Sergey Kovalev, one of his biggest weaknesses is his body. And the reason why is because of the drinking problems he's had for years. And this is not speculation. These are things that Kovalev has stated, that he drank beer every day. He could take some vodka. And, you know, then when you see him fight Andre Ward, the first time he was stopped to the body with a ferocious body attack. Now, you got to be honest and unbiased. Imagine, you know, Sean Porter, who's not known for strength, Sean Porter, who's not known for power. So you can't expect Sean Porter to unleash a vicious body attack on Errol Spence. But the fact that Sean Porter was able to affect him to the body, imagine what a Yordanis Ugas could do, a guy who specializes in body attack, who has a better boxing style. And, you know, imagine what he could do to Errol Spence, who's a bigger, stronger fighter. Imagine what Terrence Bud Crawford, with a longer reach, who's more polished, who can switch hands. Imagine what he can do to Errol Spence, especially to the body. And that is the great game plan. And that's not the only deficiency that weakens Errol Spence Jr.'s body. Errol Spence Jr. admitted himself He said, hey, I got to keep my weight in control from now on. Ain't nothing cool about blowing up 25 pounds and having to spend camp losing the weight. Now, you have to understand with that statement, if you dissect it honestly and objectively, you realize that Errol Spence Jr. is not training to be better. He's not training to do anything different. He's simply training to lose 25 pounds every single camp. It's just a weight loss camp. It shows he's not living a disciplined life of a fighter. It shows that he's not focused inside and outside the ring. And it shows that his trainer allows this because he's not telling him anything better. Ballooning up to 25 pounds plus, you know, and when people were calling him a weight bully, people were saying, well, that's nonsense. That's nonsense. When you see that 25 pounds between camps, that's an enormous amount of weight to have to drain, cut, and come back and not, you know, not be able to work on your craft, not be able to make adjustments, because we see that Errol Spence Jr.'s IQ was not there. See, his IQ showed against Mikey Garcia, but you got to understand, this is a guy you have an enormous height and reach advantage that you have to box on the outside. What about a Sean Porter who brought the fight to you, a guy who's on your level and who's used to fighting bigger men? There was no significant adjustments made. None. He literally kept the same style. Derrick James showed nothing different. And it's simply because in training camp, he's not doing the things needed. The body is Errol Spence Jr.'s biggest deficiency, and eventually it will be exploited. Once again, Unbiased, as always, it's the IBFP. Please share, like, and you must absolutely subscribe.